For our Hot Copy Halalan 2013 series, after two attempts in the presidential race in 2004 and 2010, will Jesus is Lord founder and leader, Brother Eddie Villanueva, make it to the Senate?
Brother Eddie Villanueva is the founder and leader of the Jesus is Lord movement, one of the biggest religious groups in the country, and also considered one of the biggest voting blocs. From 15 members in 1978, today the Christian sect has over 3 million members in 43 countries, counting in overseas Filipino workers. He also started the media outfit ZOTV. But Villanueva is no stranger to the world of politics. In 2004, he ran for president but lost to then-incumbent Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. He became one of the most rabid critics of her administration. In 2010, he ran again as standard-bearer of the Bangon Pilipinas Party with a campaign that offered an alternative leadership grounded on a program to eradicate corruption and restore morality in government. Villanueva's second presidential bid also ended unsuccessfully, finishing fifth out of 9 presidential candidates. Last year, his son TESDA Chairman Joel Villanueva dropped his Senate bid under the administration coalition, reportedly because of his poor showing in the surveys. Heeding public clamor, in December last year, the Elda Villanueva announced his own bid to run in the 2013 senatorial race under the Bangon Pilipinas Party, substituting senatorial candidate Israel Virgines, who withdrew his candidacy. If elected, Villanueva says he will act as a peacemaker in the divided Senate, focus on the concerns of 10 million overseas Filipino workers, and review the country's supposedly antiquated laws.
Absolutely protected. Na walang may iwanan.
All right, joining us on Hot Copy is Brother Eddie Villanueva. Good day to you, Brother Eddie.
Hi, good day din sa iyo, Karen.
All right, in 2004, you ran for the presidency and you got almost 2 million votes.
More than 2 million.
More than 2 million. In 2010, you ran again for the presidency and...
Almost 2 million.
Almost 2 million votes. Now, I just want to ask you, why do you keep wanting to run now for the Senate?
Alam mo, tinutuloy natin yung advocacy natin mula nung tayo student leader activist sa UP College of Law, sa PUP. Mm-mm. At ngayon ay nahipon nila Chief Justice Renato Puno, nila NEDA Secretary Shell Habito, at saka proponents ng BESMO na i-challenge ako. At of course, ituloy ang ating advocacy sa Senado. At ako naniniwala ang Senado is one of the best institutions na pwedeng gamitin para ma-accelerate ang economic development ng ating bansa.
Mm-mm.
At kaya nga ang dala-dala ko rito ay yung politika at ekonomiyang sagigilid sa Senado. Mga sagigilid, yung mga
Pilipino. Anong sagigilid?
Ang sagigilid ang ibig sabihin mga Pilipinong limot na sa lipunan.
Ano, nalilimutan mga nasagilid?
Ng lipunan. Nalilimutan ng lipunan, modern sagigilid niya, mga magsasaka, mga isda, manggagawa, mga tricycle driver, sidewalk vendors, jeepney bus drivers, pati OFWs, mga malilit na mga ngalakal. So, madaling salita, yon ang nasa puso ko long time ago at nahipo yon nila nung best mo. Nung,
yeah, but what's very interesting here is... it's proving that Jesus is Lord doesn't have a block vote.
No, kasi...
Because wala, how many members do you have?
Meron kaming chapter sa lahat ng cities, lahat ng probinsya.
I at 52
countries,
have,
ano?
Yes.
Kaya lang, ang sa akin kasi, nung panahon na yon, kalaban namin ang Malacanang. Pagkalaban mo ang Malacanang, it's a reality, kalaban mo ang Comelec, ano?
Okay.
Pangalawa, ang labanan doon one-on-one. Ngayon, 12 senatorial balls ang pipiliin ng sambay ng Pilipino.
Mm-mm.
So, I still believe in the innate goodness of the Filipino people. Na kahit papano, alam naman nila si Brother Eddie hindi lang evangelist, kundi tayo matagal na naging political economist,
mm-mm,
social activist, at nakulungan tayo ng dalawang beses sa pagpaglaban para sa anak sa mga masang Pilipino, no? Sa UP College of Law. At naging educator din tayo,
yeah,
longest region tayo ng biggest, mm-hmm, People's University. So, being an economist, educator, evangelist, and preacher, and social activist,
yes,
dala-dala ko yung formula. Kasi matagal ko na ito.
I have no questions on your qualifications. I'm curious, practically speaking, Brother Eddie, you need at least, especially with 2013, you have so many re-elections, you need at least 6 to 7 million votes to make it to the top 12. So my question, or put it to 8, So with 2 million votes in the last two elections, where will you get the 8 million?
Unang-una sa analysis ng Christian Coalition, 8 to 10 million ang bumubuo sa buong churches, buong Pilipinas, yung tinatawag na Body of Christ.
Yes, but they have to vote for you.
Karamihan doon ay God-loving and nation-loving Pilipinos.
Okay.
With multiplier effect.
Yes, but do we block vote? I mean, Christian churches? Iglesia clearly block votes.
Kasi we don't believe na impose me yung gusto mo sa mga members. Ano? Tayo, we practice democracy. However, ang mga tunay na nagmamahal sa Diyos at sa bayan, automatic yan eh. Ang kanilang iboboto, yung alam nilang may dalang moral leadership.
Okay.
Dalang moral leadership is the foundation of good governance, and good governance is equal to good economics, and good economics is the gateway to prosperity. Alam nila na, with due respect to all, meron tayong dala-dalang napakayamang plataforma sa Senado. Kaya ang tingin ko, yung 12 senatorables, kayang-kaya nilang isingit yung si Brother Eddie Villanueva. Dahil sayang naman yung master plan of development ng Bangon Pilipinas for many years na pinlano ng mga brainy people from different administrations.
Okay. All right. We have to answer this very quickly, bullet points. Your son Joel was supposed to be part of the Team Pinoy slate, but eventually President Aquino decided not to include him. Why did you choose to run over Joel?
Well, dahil ginaalan ko yung endorsement ni President Pinoy nung una, sabi niya sa akin, ay kailangan doon munang mamanatili sa cabinet si Joel, kaya nagbago ang kanilang isip. So, ako naman ay inidyokan ito at sinyalins ako ng leadership ng nila Chief Justice Puno, nila Shell Habito, at ng Bangon leadership na wag kong i-abandon yung advocacy ng Bangon Pilipinas.
Uh-oh. Okay, did you feel bad when President Aquino told Joel that he wouldn't be in the slate?
No, I respect President Pinoy. I think he has wisdom dahil kailangan doon niya sa cabinet si Joel, no? At bata pa naman daw si Joel. Nag-usap kami ng one-on-one. At naintindihan niya nung ako dalhin ni Chief Justice Puno sa kay Presidente at nagpaalam kami na ako itatambo. Okay. Natutuwa pa nga si Presidente. Nagdadaling ko yung aking advocacy patungo Senado at all out support sa Daang
Matuwid. Alright. Now, my source tells me that una, a former President Estrada wants to support you. Well, include you in the una senatorial slate. Apparently, masama loob nila doon sa common candidates that they want to drop them and then just support you.
Well, I courteously declined. I think,
you did?
Dahil gusto ko kasi yung kaibigan ko si Senator lahat eh. Kaibigan ko ang Pinoy administration. Kaibigan ko rin yung una leader. So, marami
so,
ang kaibigan.
So, Erap invited you?
Well,
when?
A few weeks ago.
What did he say?
Well, ang sa kanya lang, kung gusto ko, una, nagpadala sa akin ng abogado. Pangalawa, pumunta mismo sa bahay. Nagkaroon lang kami ng fellowship. Ano? At baka rin sakaling magustuhan ko,
to be what?
Willing siya naman na
magustuhan mo
sumuporta, no?
Okay. For you to be in the una slate.
Well, may mga peers kasi sa akin eh. I want to respect the confidentiality of their...
alam ko na nga eh. Wala nang confidentiality. Okay.
So ako naman, Karen, I prefer to be independent, no?
Oo.
Kasi ang aking susulong sa Senado kasi talagang no-nonsense landmark legislation.
But wait, I need to finish this first. So what did you tell Erap?
Well, I thank him so much, for his trust.
Was Erap there in the room?
Well, of course.
Okay, he was personally there.
Yes.
Okay. Who were they going to remove in the slate?
Ah, wala namang sinabing ganun.
It's not cheese?
Wala namang sinabi.
Because what I heard was it's Senator Cheese.
Basta kung gusto ko raw, malaman lang niya. Dahil nang hinayang daw siya doon sa aking platform of government.
Okay.
Na alam niya na malaking magagawa.
Okay.
Sa
so you have turned down, just for a head start, for the record, you have turned down the una offer.
Well, with courtesy, no? At, well, ang galing naman kasi mag-cross-examine.
So they did offer you to be in the una slate.
Well, no comment ako. Pasensya ka na, Karen, kasi I have to respect nga the confidentiality. Uh-oh.
But that would have really helped your campaign. If you were under the una slate, you would be campaigning with Erap, Binay, that would honestly, I mean, objectively help you. Why turn it
kasi
down?
Kasi I have been supporting Didaang Matuwid na pamamahala ni Pinoy. So,
hindi ba sila matuwid?
I prepare, hindi, pareho naman sila, no? Mga kaibigan ko naman lahat yan. I prepare to be neutral to them.
Ang hirap na yung situation.
Because, alam mo, Karen, I believe na the God-loving and nation-loving Filipinos in our time right now, I believe it's very, very possible for Brother Eddie and some independent-minded candidates to really be elected.
Okay. Pero hindi pa Daang Matuwid ang una?
Hindi. I cannot judge, you know? Kasi nga...
It's a yes or a no?
Lahat naman na yan. I respect their qualifications. Lahat naman sila, I believe they're qualified.
Are they corrupt?
Only God knows. And you know... Basta sa akin, I don't want to judge, you know. In addition to some landmark legislations na pangarap kong dalhin sa Senado that can accelerate the reformation of our economic, social, and political systems.
Okay. And, all right. No, you're really making my day. Is Una corrupt? Only God knows. Okay. Wait, quickly. Okay, very quickly.
Oh, yes.
RH bill. Now it's a law.
Well, maghintay tayo na implementation, ano?
But are you for RH or not?
I am against all forms of abortion because abortion is murder per se.
Okay.
However, I am absolutely in favor of sound family planning,
condoms and pills,
and all the so-called responsible parenthood programs. I'm in favor of that because I love the future of the children.
Mm-hmm.
So, ang body of Christ kasi tsaka ang coalition, Christian coalition, divided sila eh.
Mm-hmm.
Merong pro and against.
Mm-hmm.
Ako, consistent ang aking stand.
Okay.
I'm against all forms of abortion.
Uh-oh.
But I'm in favor of responsible parenthood.
Okay.
Dahil because God himself is a God of planning. At saka we have to take care of the future of the children.
Okay. Now, is using the pill a form of abortion?
Well,
yes or no?
Hindi. Pagkakaalam ko, ano man ang pills, ano man ang mga methods, as long as walang pinapatay na life.
Mm.
That's very clear.
Okay lang yun.
Well, it depends on the conviction of everyone.
We have to respect the couple. But for you, you're a preacher. What you say is important for Christians.
Well,
so, what do you think?
Very clear ako. As long as there is no abortion, whatever the methods
are. No life.
Well, no life being killed.
Uh-oh.
And as long as the conviction of the couple do not violate God's commandments and the moral standards of civilized society.
Mm-mm.
And without jeopardizing the interest of our countrymen.
Okay.
Ako, kung ako, balansyado ako.
Okay. Alright, quickly, divorce. I can predict your answer, but go, quick.
God hates divorce, however, with some exceptions.
Oh,
with exceptions.
What are the exceptions to divorce?
Kapag mayroong infidelity.
This is a very interesting
infidelity
answer.
And domestic violence and injustices, those are exceptions. But the perfect will of God is to strengthen the family.
All right, but are you trying to tell me, Brother Eddie, that you think divorce should be legalized in the Philippines? Because you said God hates divorce, but there are exceptions.
Yung exceptions.
Okay.
Kaya nga, pag tayo nasa Senado, if ever, by the grace of God and with the help of the God-loving and nation-loving Filipinos, pag-aaralan natin mabuti yan. Paano natin ikakrap ang isang batas.
Mm-mm.
Na hindi nagbabiolate sa kalooban ng Diyos, at the same time, giving freedom to the spouses.
Pero most senators want annulment, cheaper annulment.
Well, sa akin kasi, kinakailangan kasi magkaroon ng amendments eh. Importante yung suited doon sa tinatawag kong exceptional cases na wala kang binabiolate. Malinis ang konsyensya mo. Pero, nabibigyan mo ng better alternative ang society.
Now, I'm curious, do you think the Catholic Church is still powerful in the Philippines? The truth?
Well, nobody can just underestimate the dominating religion in our country. Pero, I believe majority of the Catholics are progressive-minded.
Okay.
And I believe they are enlightened people.
Mm-mm.
I believe their priority is for the good of the country.
Okay, death penalty.
Death penalty, absolutely. I'm in favor of death penalty only for heinous crimes.
But
only
believe ako sa iyo, you are, do you know what? Something has dawned on me. You're a preacher, but you're not a conservative.
The Bible is very clear.
Wow.
I can present overwhelming evidence.
Yes,
that God is in favor of death penalty as long as for heinous crimes. Kasi, kawawa naman ang bansa natin kung kayangan ang daming mga shocking horrible crimes eh.
But how do you solve the problem of the poor never get good lawyers? They're usually the fall guys. They're usually not the one guilty.
Kaya nga ako isa sa dahil lang kaya nagdesisyon akong tumakbo ng senador eh. Dahil ako ay nakulong nga ako against injustices eh, no?
Mm-mm.
Kaya tututukan ko rin yan, yung tungkol sa justice system. Kasi yung problema natin sa bansa natin, number one, poverty and injustices. At may mga root causes yan eh. Kaya nga doon sa mga batas na dapat ilagay dyan, talagang it will in effect lead the nation to genuine national transformation.
Mm-mm.
Hindi may iwasan sa national transformation ang little overhauling ng economic and social and political systems.
Okay. All right. I'm quite curious. Syntax law.
Ang syntax law, okay yung naaprubahan na yun eh, no?
Mm.
Pero para sa akin, dapat ayaw lang pala ng smoking. Very clear ang batas. Na no smoking.
Alam nga naman, hindi tayo magbenta ng sigarilyo. Mahirap naman dyan.
Hindi.
Hindi ako naninigarilyo, pero di ba?
Oo nga, pero meron namang advantage yan eh. Yung sinasabi nila, mag-increase ang revenue. At yung revenue naman na yan, mapupunta sa mga sa education, sa health. It is part of the justification. Pero, andyan na yun eh. Ang importante.
Are you pro-syntax or no? Yes or no?
Kung ako ang nasa tayo ng national leadership, I can craft a special law that will serve the end purpose without immediately destroying the hopes of the planters in the north, ano?
Yeah, but at least cigarettes are more expensive now.
Kaya nga wala tayong magagawa, andyan na 'yan. So importante ang implementation niyan, yung budget, yung matutulungan niya, may income diyan should be properly allotted to Mm-mm. priority projects.
Okay, but I'm curious, if you were sitting in the Senate or in Congress, you would have not have voted for syntax?
I will scrutinize
okay.
and study carefully.
Spoken like a true legislator. I will study further. Gun ban. Well, are you satisfied with how President Aquino is actually handling crime?
No, to me that is not crime. He's handling crime?
Right now. No, handling crime. Do you watch the news? There are so many people right now. Ang nangyayari, may CCTV na papasok. SM Mega Mall robbery. The crime in the Philippines. Are you satisfied?
Akala ko si Presidente. Anyway.
How the President is handling peace and order.
Yeah, I am against absolute total ban, no? Dapat, ang issuance ng license must be strictly enforced at merong proper psychiatric, psychological test. At talagang walang palakasan, walang lagayan. Kaya kailangan doon ang political will.
So you do, I've interviewed some senatorial candidates that are absolutely for gunless. I mean, Senator Loren Legarda absolutely said ayaw niya ng baril, but she did say law enforcers should have guns. But do you believe civilians should carry guns?
The so-called respectable civilians na...
Like who?
Depende yun sa screening ng proper government agency, you know? Kung yung mga civilian ay merong threats sa halimbawa sa possibility na sila ay ma-hold up, halimbawa meron silang threats, hindi tayo po pwedeng maging absolute gunless society.
Wow, okay.
That is a utopian state, ano? We have to be realistic. Ang importante, ma-minimize, if not completely obliterate, crimes. Kaya, ang importante yung enforcement, eh.
Uh-oh.
Kaya sa akin, mahigpit ako sa kone. Kaya lang.
Stricter enforcement.
Oo, siyempre. Kaya nga, plano ko mag-gumawa ng special law na lahat ng hindi nag-i-implement ng good laws sa Philippines, dapat may penalty.
Ano? Death?
Well, whatever it is, ha? Kapag sa analysis natin ay hinus,
okay.
Iba yung hinus, iba yung hindi naman.
I'm curious. Senatorial JB Ejercito is in favor of legalizing marijuana for medicinal purposes. You?
Well, I'm absolutely legalizing any form of sins.
Against any
subject matter na against the will and the commands of God and the morality of the society.
Marijuana.
I'm absolutely against. Pero kung medical ang pangangailangan, iba 'yon, exceptional 'yon. Gagamit ang mga doktor ng kung morphine ay kailangan dun sa pasyente sa hospital. That's a different case.
Uh-oh. So you really are progressive as a person. You're not really very conservative, Brother Eddie.
If you know my life, I used to be a social activist and political economist for so long. That's why I've been on the streets. The parliament, the street parliament, is my community for many years of my life before Jesus Christ arrested me. As a matter of fact, my philosophy before, since there is no God, I was made to believe that there is no God, that the only hope of the Philippines to establish a just and human society, unite the masses, and advance the national democratic revolution.
Okay.
That's my. But
all right.
Now, it's different.
Okay, Jesus Christ has arrested you, but very quickly, for the spirit of transparency, you are running for the Senate. How much donations does Jesus is Lord movement get a month?
You know, I never interfere in the finance department of the ministry.
But
and
you
remember
must have
this.
An idea.
No. Yan magugulat ang mga tao. Ni pera nga, hindi ko kabisado ang itsura, no? Kasi hindi ako materialistic eh. Pangalawa,
but you don't know how much donations Jesus is Lord movement.
Absolutely. I have to confess. I don't know anything because I don't want to interfere in the finance ministry of the church.
Okay, but where is Jesus is Lord spending its donations? Because if I were a member of your church and I'm asking, do you know where they spend
it? Do you know that the church of JIL for the last 34 years has reached all places, cities, provinces, Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, and also having an eye care compassion ministry in 52 countries of the world.
Okay, so do you know where you spend your donations? The church?
Well, they are being used for the expansion of the ministry.
Okay, for the expansion.
Helping the poor, helping the needy, and you know, the bulk of our congregations are poor and poorest among the poor.
Now, where will Brother Eddie get his money for a TV advertisement?
Do you know that I was gifted by the Lord many years ago of a franchise for Zoe Broadcasting Network?
Yes.
It's a miracle.
But where did you get the money to buy Zoe Broadcasting Network?
No, I did not buy it. I applied. Nung una, nag-apply ako ng church muna, rejected. Nag-apply ako ng Jesus the Healer Foundation, rejected. Because commercial franchise, commercial frequency cannot be given to the church,
to the
religion, because of separation of church and state.
But you were.
And even the non-profit. So what they advised me, you applied first for franchise.
Yeah.
And by faith, I got the franchise miraculously without spending a single centavo.
What is this? What year?
So we're broadcasting.
No, what year?
During Aquino's time.
Okay, Cory. But now wait, just for the record, this franchise is now GMA News TV.
No, this franchise owns the so-called Channel 11.
Which is GMA News TV?
Oh, yeah, prime black timer namin, ang GMA 7.
Yes.
From 8 to 12.
Okay.
At pagkatapos meron kami UHF na Channel 33, Light TV.
Okay.
So, tsaka yung DJB. Sa,
okay. Now, did you report in your statement of assets and liabilities what you earned from the Zoe Broadcasting franchise?
You will be surprised that the Zoe Broadcasting Network is included as top 20 taxpayers, 20 corporations in the country.
How much did you pay last year? I want to know.
Well, but if my memory is right, more or less around 10 to 12 million, you know.
Okay, in a year?
Yeah, in a year. That was information to me by the accounting department, you know.
So is
but
it
you
safe?
Saw,
yeah. But is it safe to say, Brother Eddie, then that if you are paying 10 to 12 million in a year, Brother Eddie is earning at least, just from TV, 100 million?
Well, I'm sorry. I beg to disagree with that.
More?
I'm only receiving living allowance from our Zoe Broadcasting Network. You will be surprised because our records are open.
Yes, but
open
what will
to
you
BIR.
Use? How? What money are you using now for campaign purposes?
Well, our little savings and some contributions, some donations of volunteers. You know, my asset is the so-called nationwide Brave Hearts. Okay. These are the volunteers buying their own t-shirts.
How much have you spent?
I don't know exactly, you know.
Pwede pa yun. Jack Enrile says 30, Sunny Angara claims 10. Well, Cynthia Villar refuses
I'm different.
To say.
My condition in accepting the challenge to run is that I will never, never borrow money from anyone.
Okay.
Because I will give my life. Now, if you cannot find any solution, I cannot accept.
Okay, now, yeah. Quick question. If one of your church members donates and says, Brother Eddie, you can use this donation for your campaign.
That is accounted.
But will you, that's okay?
Of course. Of course, we have a complete accounting system.
Okay.
Because Bangon Pilipinas is is composed of people with absolute integrity.
Okay.
From different churches.
All right.
May piso-piso, mayroong kung gusto magbigay, pero hindi ako mahawak.
Okay,
I entrusted everything to the finance ministry.
So you
finance
don't know
department.
How much you've spent?
I don't know yet, you know.
Okay.
They told me, wala akong pakialam, basta yung platform of government, i-present mo, and then you do your best as a candidate. Di, para akong gladiator eh. No? Sinama ako sa labanan, kaya nga sabi ko, tungkulin niyo, suportahan naman ako.
Okay.
Hanggang ngayon, walang TV ads, ano?
Wala pa?
Wala
pa.
Kaming TV
I have
ads.
Not seen it.
Oh, yeah. Kaya ang problema nga, sana, yung mga mayayamang network, bigyan naman ng consideration yung mga mahirap na kandidato, sapagkat, wala naman, hindi naman kami nangangalakal eh.
Would you consider yourself mahirap na kandidato?
Of course, wala kaming pera eh.
But you own a TV network, a franchise.
Yeah, the franchise, but I am not selling it. I am not, ang kinikita nun, magugulat ka.
Ano?
Sufficiente lang para swelduhan ng more than 100 employees.
Okay, all right.
Ako, ang tinatanggap ko lang, you can examine.
Okay,
you
how
can,
much?
You ask the BIR.
For Zoe.
You can ask the
okay.
BIR. Madalas kami punta ng BIR.
Oh, how much, sir?
Ang tinatanggap lang namin, yung living allowance.
How much?
100,000.
A month. Okay.
Oh, sa akin, oh.
Oh, from the
May tights pa ako, ha?
Okay, we're gonna take a quick break when we return. This is very interesting. We'll continue our conversation. Apparently, I just found out that Brother Eddie Villanueva is more progressive and open than the other candidates running for the Senate. All right, we have to be out at 8:55. All right, Bangon Pilipinas candidate Brother Eddie Villanueva is here. Look at the pictures. Describe first word that comes to your mind.
Brother Mike Bilarde.
Don't tell me who he is. Describe. First word, don't edit too much.
Well, of course, I respect everyone and he is preaching in his ministry.
Ano yun? Do you believe in him?
Well,
would you call him friend, enemy, competitor?
You know, I believe in every human being. There is that innate
goodness. No, brother, ito muna, si Brother Mike.
Well, to me, I consider him as a friend.
Okay, next. Next.
I respect that man.
I think
he's the Supreme
Manalo.
Minister,
yeah.
Ka Eduardo Villanueva Manalo.
Are they a cult?
INC.
Is INC a cult?
Well, I'm not in a position to judge anyone, you know. As I've said, I believe that all preachers, they're so sincere in believing what they are teaching or preaching. But as far as judging them, I have to scrutinize everything.
Is INC the right theology? Is it biblical?
Well, as I have said, I'm following the word of God, not to judge anyone.
Okay, all right. Next. Ang hirap, hindi ka mahuli, ha? Next. Oh! Ah, si ano? Ang
brother,
dating Daan.
Brother Eli Soriano.
Okay.
I think Brother Eli Soriano.
Okay. Yeah.
He is the leader of Dating Daan Ministry.
Yeah, I know that. The description.
Well,
he gets into fights on TV.
Well, that's why my prayer is for all religious leaders to exercise a spirit of sportsmanship and respect everyone.
Okay, describe him.
Well,
One word?
Well, I have to consult my dictionary.
Ano ba to? Unsafe, next. Oh, Diyos ko. Oh.
Ayan. Kala ko ikaw eh.
Hindi ito. One eh.
Well, of course, former President Gloria Macapagal-Arroyo.
Oh, one word.
Well, I am praying for her
one
healing.
Word, guy. You know? Description, one word. JV said ruthless. Cynthia said hardworking. One word, go. Well, Lauren said veterans. It's not a description either, but go. One word.
You know, all I can say is that meron siyang mga good achievements din naman eh.
Okay.
Kaya ako, I don't want to condemn anyone eh.
Okay, but one word.
One word.
Somebody said plunderer. Who was that? I think the other day.
Well, a person is supposed to be innocent unless proven otherwise.
So what's the one word?
Well,
with GMA.
She is, I think she is being tried in court.
Two words. Next na nga, just go. Okay, one word.
Well, President Era is a charismatic political leader.
Okay, charismatic is at least one word. Yeah. Okay, next. One word.
Well, is still bachelor but lovable.
Ano ba yun? Still bachelor but lovable? Okay, next. One word.
Well, small but terrible.
Alam mong galing mo ha, hindi ka pala one word, Brother Eddie. Sa'yo, describe by phrase. Charismatic ba? Single but lovable, small but terrible. Ano si Binay? Small?
But terrible.
But terrible. Terrible in what way?
Well, you know, we were together during the first quarter storms.
Ah, okay. But, so terrible in that way. Okay. Wala na ba? Wala nang photo. All right. So Brother Eddie Villanueva, do you think, kasi ito ang tanong ko, sir. Pasensya ka na.
Okay. Open ako sa lahat ng questions.
If you lose a third time, do you consider that humiliating already?
Oh, no. To me, Abraham Lincoln, kung si Abraham Lincoln nag-give up.
Actually, lost 19 times.
Walang,
am I right? Is my history right?
I know, 7 or 9 times.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Kung nag-give up si Abraham Lincoln, walang emancipation ng slaves. Kung nag-give up si Martin Luther King Jr., walang sa kanyang civil rights na pinaglaban, siguro walang black president ngayon sa Amerika.
Mm-mm.
Kung si Rizal Bonifacio Mabini del Pilar ay nag-give up, and our leader, our heroes from Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao ay give up, siguro wala tayong ganitong kalayaan. Ngayon, ang pangarap lang, simpleng-simple. Ako yung naging radical na aktivista, progressive economist, and social activist before, bago ako naging evangelist.
Mm-mm.
Ang pangarap lang, simpleng-simple, emancipation or liberation of the masses of our people from the bondage of poverty and injustices.
Mm-mm. Now, what can Brother Eddie offer if you are sitting in the Senate that other senatorials cannot offer?
Well, I believe naman they can also offer, but I will definitely bring in the so-called moral leadership in addition to landmark legislations that I'm planning. And moral leadership is the foundation of good governance, and good governance
is equal to economic. What is one landmark leadership, sir? Give me, because I'm rushing, I'm very curious,
What's your question again?
Give me one landmark legislation that you want to pass.
The so-called emancipation of OFWs by...
How? What do you mean?
Well, I will prod the Office of the President and the Department of Foreign Affairs to make treaty or international agreements through bilateral, multilateral agreements with foreign countries of the world for the alleviation of the side plight of more than 11 million OFWs scattered abroad. And also, of course, the modernization of agriculture, fishery, and tourism.
Mm-mm.
Because I believe it can produce domino effects and emancipating our people. Kasi I'm in favor of economic growth as long as it is inclusive, not just exclusive for the few.
Okay. All right, Brother Eddie Villanueva, thank you for coming to the show.
Thank you.
I just want to say that I've been to Brother Eddie's house before. Long, long ago, I think 2010 elections or 2004. I was in ABS already. You still live in your very simple home. And that was a family-owned property which you donated to Jesus is Lord movement, just to make it fair.
Thank you very
much.
Yes,
because I remember it was such a very simple house. You prayed for me when I went there, and half of the land, you donated it to the church.
The whole land.
The whole land, you donated. It was very big donated to the church.
Multi-million work.
All right, okay. What's your number during elections?
31.
kaya! Okay. So, kaya pala 31, Derek, is because you shade. You shade. So, Brother Eddie Villanueva is number 31 in the ballot. Okay, on that note, let's get started today. Replay of this interview is at 6 p.m. tonight. I'm Karen Davila. Have a good day, everyone. And 4:30 a.m. tomorrow, I'll see you again and weekend replays of Brother Eddie's interview, and we'll also post the link. Think carefully before you vote. We hope KidStart is helping you get to know the candidates more, make good choices, character, track record, brain, integrity, everything, and the ideas they have to offer. Progressive pala si Brother Eddie. Thank you very much. See you again tomorrow.